Welcome to Linux Saint YouTube channel. Today we will gonna see the best Linux distros for gaming. When it comes to gaming, Windows is always the go-to operating system. Almost every game out there is made keeping in mind the Windows operating system. But with more support for games, Linux has become a lot more gamer friendly. Now it supports more games, although it does not do without Windows emulators. One of the main reasons Linux widespread acceptance lags behind Windows operating system is because of the minimal support for games. In the past, gamers could only play text-based games using the command line. However, several distributions support gaming due to the recent progressive development and significant advances in Linux desktop. Many of these distributions provide a great gaming experience with reliable graphical user interface applications and features. Now, you should keep three things in your mind before choosing a Linux distribution for gaming purpose. Number one, the distribution should be easy to use. Number two, the software tools that you need to get started should be readily available and easy to install. Number three, the distribution should be resource friendly. Linux users have the choice between numerous distributions with different desktop environments. Gamers need to see which is suitable for their purposes. Technically, any Linux distro can be used for gaming, but some distributions are precisely developed for gaming on Linux. These distributions can be up and running with a few steps, like installing the operating system, installing Steam or Lucas, and here you are ready to play. So that is why we will take a look at some of the distributions that have been discussed in recent times. The first distro I'm going to talk about is Ubuntu Game Pack. Ubuntu Game Pack is one of the best Linux distros for every gaming enthusiast. The great thing about Ubuntu Game Pack is that it ships with Steam and Lutris game platform, which helps to reach games with ease. Not just that, but the Linux distribution also comes with Wine clients, which means you can also install Windows games. Ubuntu Game Pack, in a general sense, does not arrange your games by default. As opposed to that, it shares a gaming environment where you can play games with different extensions on your machine without the need for any additional dependencies. Anyway, it does offer a vast repository of games to one-click download. Now, before discussing the pros and cons of the Ubuntu Game Pack, let's discuss the system requirements you should meet to use this distro. All you need is a RAM of 2 GB and storage space of 20 GB of hardware space. Now, let's discuss some prominent pros and cons to get it perfectly. Pros to use this distribution is that it is compatible for playing games online and it supports for all games, Windows, Steam, Linux and console. The con you should be aware of is that its performance is a bit slow. Now let's discover another best distribution for gaming, that is Fedora Game Spin. Fedora Game Spin is by default compatible and limited to run Linux games. It is what makes Fedora apart from others, as hundreds of Linux games are pre-installed in this distribution. Unlike most of the Linux distribution, this is fast, light and stable. If you wish to have play on Linux, Wine or Steam games, you need to have them installed manually since they don't come pre-installed by default. Aside from that, you also need new drivers installed since it does not come with the installation. The prime reason for using this distribution is that it consumes low resources and needs a small space to operate. Although it does not support all games, it is the most faster operating system to play all Linux games. Moreover, it is easy to install. Now comes to the system requirement you need. You need a 2 GHz processor, minimum 1 GB RAM is required, minimum 10 GB hard disk is required, whereas for playing Steam games, Intel HD graphics or AMD Radeon 8500 is required. Now it is time to discuss the pros and cons. So let's not waste the time and jump to the conclusion. So Fedora Game Spin's pros are that it comes with thousands of pre-installed Linux games. It is easy to install and run games very fast, whereas the con is that it does not have support for many games. Coming towards the next distribution, that is Pop OS. Pop OS is a free and open source designed by System 76. Since it is based on Ubuntu, Pop OS comes with a GNOME desktop environment. It has a very fast and fluid navigation system, along with some neat and tidy workflows that provide users with optimal performance and an excellent user experience. This distribution has exceptional built-in GPU system, and you can easily install the GPU that suits your system. Since it is based on Ubuntu, Pop OS also has LTS versions, and users can use the system for a long time without going through any major issues. With Ubuntu, you can install software like Lutris, GameHub, and Steam Proton directly from the Pop OS App Store. Let's discuss the system requirements for Pop OS. All you need is a 2GB RAM, 16GB storage, a 64-bit compatible processor, but for an optimum experience, you need 4GB RAM and a fairly decent multi-core CPU. Now, if we talk about Pro, then Pop OS makes GNOME look good, and System 76 is a hardware company. It configures machines to ship with Linux pre-installed. This means its entire business model centers around delivering a quality desktop Linux experience. Let's look at the drawback. That is, it supports only 64-bit system. Some older PCs still have 32-bit processors. This limitation will be a major con for those who use an older PC, since they will not be able to install, run it in a virtual machine or live media. Now, few gamers are inclined toward content creation, so the Manjaro Gaming Edition is dedicated to those gamers. We could say this because this distribution comes pre-installed with tools for creating content. Some of these include Audacity, streaming apps, screenshot tools, chatting software, and many more. Its graphical application installer comes with multiple sources such as Flatpak, Snap, AUR, the official repository of Manjaro, and also allows the direct building of apps from their source. This makes Manjaro our style Linux distribution, and the latest versions of emulators or runtimes like DOSBox, Dolphin, Vine, Vintrix, or VKD3D are also available in the package repositories. Well, I would not recommend this to new Linux user, but if you think you can handle troubleshooting your system if something goes wrong, then you can give it a try. Let's see the system requirements for Manjaro Linux Gaming. You need a minimum 1GB RAM, minimum 25GB hard disk, minimum 1.2GHz processor, and a high-end graphic card for playing graphic games. And if we look at its pros, then it supports all types of games. It supports updates gaming drivers, whereas some games are not compatible with this distribution. Coming towards the next best distribution that I will gonna discuss with you is Laka. Users who want to transform their modern or old computer in a retro gaming console can go for lightweight Laka Linux distribution. It builds upon the popular RetroArch emulator, thus Laka can emulate a wide variety of systems and offers some useful features such as automatic drive-byte recognition, multiplayer, rewinding, netplay, and shaders. It is available as a bootable USB image for PCs. There are also versions of ARM-based machines such as Raspberry Pi. This distribution supports most keyboards as well as wireless PS3 and PS4 controllers, along with Xbox 360 controllers. It comes with a clear and easy to follow documentation. One of the drawbacks is that it does not come with pre-installed games. It is an open source distribution that has a strong community of gamers, developers, and designers that make it so successful. If you talk about the system requirements to use this distribution is, you need minimum 10GB hard disk, minimum 1GB RAM, and almost all older and newer CPUs are supported by it. The pros of using this distribution is that it supports all retro games and it comes with so many retro emulators. Whereas the con is that it does not support high-end games. Now, the next distribution we are going to talk about is Steam OS. Steam OS is probably the most well-known and used cross-platform Linux game distribution based on Debian Linux. It packs a large assortment of entertainment software and can be thought of as the complete Linux gaming platform. With Steam OS installed, you will not only have unlimited access to multiple online games, but you will also be able to join the active gamer community around the world. Users can also create their content and share it with many other community members. Steam OS does not have many functions and features. It does not even have an image viewer or file manager, but you can download and install software using the GNOME desktop environment. If you talk about system requirements, you need Intel or AMD 64-bit capable processor, minimum 4 GB of RAM is required, minimum 500 GB of hard disk is required, and if we talk about pros, then it supports for many graphic cards. It has a smooth gaming experience. While the con is that it runs Steam games only. Now, the last distribution in my list is Sparky Linux. If you are a gamer who's into playing games on emulators, Sparky Linux Game Over Edition is for you. The Sparky Linux Game Over Edition may be one of the best Linux distribution for gamers available. You can access numerous emulators through a quick launch bar. With Sparky Linux, you get multiple games and a Steam client. With Sparky Game Over Edition, you will get many pre-installed tools that will hand over you a better Linux gaming experience. On the top, it has Lutris for running cross-platform games together with support for Steam games within the box. Moreover, you can play online games also through Chrome browser. Now, if you talk about the system requirements, minimum CPU support i686 32-bit or AMD 64 64-bit, Pentium 4 or AMD Athlon. Minimum RAM required is 512 MB and minimum 20 GB hard disk is required. Now let's see the pros of this awesome distribution. It supports for all types of games. Pre-installed tools like Wine are available. It comes with Linux games. And if we see the cons, then it does not support updated graphics card and not robust for running many Steam games. Choosing the best Linux distribution for gaming may seem a challenge, but checking reviews give you a deeper understanding of which distribution is perfect for your gaming needs. Which among the distros we have discussed you think is better? Do you need help choosing the right one for you? Tell us what you think or reach out to us in the comments below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you so much.